Restorative justice is not a new idea. In fact, it's been part of the Canadian justice system for over 40 years, but it's still in the process of growing into a fully functional system.
In many cases, we are seeing the trends continue wherein the life expectancy of Indigenous peoples has not really turned the corner. There are more children in care today than ever before. There's huge numbers of people in prisons across the country.
Rai Morin, Executive Director of the National Center for Truth and Reconciliation, says the problem isn't going away overnight.
On the other side of the TRC call to action are the structural reforms that we really need, and that's the education work, the changes to society. It takes all of these things to be in sync with one another, and some of the really hard work in terms of resolving the crisis is the work, unfortunately, of generations.
Now that's where the idea behind restorative justice comes in. Jerry Daniels, the Grand Chief for the Southern Chiefs organization, says he sees restorative justice as a chance to engage everyone.
For us, we have people in the community and we promote and bring people together. We bring our elders together, we bring our community leaders together, and we focus on people.
He says the model is well received within the community.
Southern Chiefs organization has been able to bring more than 40% more deferrals from the court system, so you're having less people who are being incarcerated.
Correctional Services Canada says it approaches crimes and conflict as harm done to people. The restorative justice model takes a three-pronged approach focusing on healing victims, making offenders accountable, and involving the community to create healthier, safer communities. Representatives from different organizations in Winnipeg came together this week to learn how they, too, can play a part in moving forward. This year's theme is inspiring innovation and including integrated culture as part of healing. In Winnipeg, Rachel Crowe, Spreading Wings, City News.